And, wow, I fixed these icons yesterday, but they are back to whatever way they were before. Let's open AppGameKit or AGK2. Wow, this opens really fast. Holy macro. And I'm going to open, let me see, what am I going to open? And let's go to Box2d. Let's open this project and let's run it. And whoa, they have physics. Okay, so I'm going to go over this very, very, very quickly. And it's not that hard. So let me just copy this on a notepad. And we are going to delete all this here. Okay, so we're going to redo this again. So if you run this now, you're going to notice that nothing happens. This is the size of the screen. We don't need to worry about that right now. Virtual resolution. Okay. So the first part loads the background. Okay, this is the background. So let me open the project so you can see what's going on. Let's go to media. And here is my background. And I'm going to open it in the Photoshop. This is the size you will need for a mobile game. So let me just change this image. And let's see if we can rip something here. How about this one? Somebody needs a new mouse. And let's make clouds. Clouds. Oh, oops. I forgot to fill the area. Okay, so that's our background. You don't need to end the statements with a semicolon, so you just leave them like that. You hit enter. Let's load the other image, which is the ball. This is the object number. This is the image right here. And just to be funny, we're gonna change it on the Photoshop. I'm gonna make it some sort of angry bird. Okay, we can make the blue one. Let's make the red one or something like the red one. Let's save this. Oops, I didn't make a backup. And I'm gonna run this. I loaded the image, but now we need to display it. So let's do that. We're gonna create our first sprite. And you simply type create a sprite 1 1 object number. And this is the instance number. Let's run this. And there is our angry bird. Let's position the angry bird. Set a sprite position, the object number, and these are the coordinates. So let's make another sprite. This will be instance number 2 of the same object. And we're going to set the position of that to 60 on the X, 0 on the Y. Let's try it out. Then we have 2. Let's create another sprite. Copy, paste. This one's going to be 3. Maybe I should zoom in. Let's copy set position, and this is going to be 3. This is going to be double the space, 120. Try it out. There you go. Let's create another sprite, paste it. This will be 4, and let's copy set position, 4, and this will be 180. Try it out. There you go, that's 4 of them. Let's make one more sprite, paste it. Sprite number 5. And we're gonna set the position. So this will be number 5. And for the X position, we're gonna go 240. Okay, let's run this. Wow, we have 5 sprites. Now we just need to give them physics. Let's apply Box2D to the first sprite. And let's run this. Whoa, we have now physics. Let's do the same thing for the rest of the birds. Number 2, number 3. Yeah, run this. Wow, we're gonna do them all. Let's try this out. Wow, and we now have physics. So you can see that this is extremely simple. There's nothing to it. Thanks for watching, and I will see you in the next video. Bye now.